Lecture 6, Organization of Comparison, Contrast Essays, Point-by-Point Organization, Block Organization. Learning Objectives. Study point-by-point organization, define block organization, clarify comparison and contrast signal words. Plan of the lecture. Organization of Comparison, Contrast Essays, Point-by-point organization, the third block organization, comparison and contrast signal words, comparison signal words, contrast signal words. In a comparison contrast essay, you explain the similarities and the differences between two items. Comparison and contrast is a very common pattern in most academic fields. It is also a common type of essay test question. You might encounter questions such as this. Compare the forms of government of Great Britain and the United States. Compare the characters of Uncle Malik and his nephew in a William Saroyan's short story, The Poem Granite Trees. Compare and contrast methods for promoting a new business, product or service. The first key to writing a successful comparison contrast essay is to organize it carefully. One way to organize a comparison contrast essay is to use point-by-point organization. The other way to organize a comparison contrast essay is to arrange all the similarities together in a block and all the differences together in a block. You could discuss either the similarities first or the differences first. The number of paragraphs in each block depends on the topic. For some topics, you may write about all the similarities in a single paragraph. For other topics, you may need to discuss each similarity in a separate paragraph. The same is true for differences. Of course, some topics may have one paragraph of similarities and several paragraphs of differences, or vice versa. So let's talk about comparison and contrast signal words. The second key to writing successful comparison contrast essays is the appropriate use of comparison and contrast signal words. These are words that introduce points of comparison and points of contrast. It is not sufficient simply to describe each item that you are comparing. You must refer back and forth to, for example, job X and job Y, and use comparison and contrast signal words to show what is the same and what is different about them. Of course, you should also use transition signals such as first, second, one, another, the final, for example, and in conclusion, in addition to these special ones. So let's talk about comparison signal words. Transition words and phrases. Similarly, for example, human workers can detect malfunctions in machinery similarly, likewise, a robot can be programmed to detect equipment malfunctions. Also, human workers can detect malfunctions in machinery, a robot can also. 2. Human workers can detect malfunctions in machinery, a robot can too. So, let's speak about subordinates. For example, as robots can detect malfunctions in machinery as just as human workers can. Just as, note, Use a comma when as and just as show comparison, even when the dependent clause follows the independent clause, as in the above example. Contrast signal words fall into two main groups according to their meaning. The words in the first group show a relationship that is called concession. The words in the second group show an opposition relationship. Concession signal words indicate that the information in one clause is not the result you expect from the information given in the other clause. Although I studied all night, I failed the exam, for example. My failing the exam is not the result you might expect from the information. In a comparison contrast essay, a writer must do the following. First, identify and explain three or more key points that two or more subjects have in common. Second, show the similarities and differences between these points. Third, develop a thesis indicating his or her position regarding the two subjects. The thesis may indicate that one subject is stronger than the other, and that both subjects have strengths, or that both subjects possess noteworthy flaws. There are two ways to organize a comparison contrast essay. First, block approach. This organizational pattern is most effective when used on short essays, such as in class essays. The body of such an essay is organized by discussing one subject, point by point, in complete detail before moving on to the next subject. The writer should select points by which both subjects can be examined. The number of body paragraphs will be determined by the number of points discussed in the essay. Introduction. Introduce the two or more subjects being compared and lead to a thesis, statement, or argument. Example. There are benefits to shopping at both Whole Foods and Safeway, but Whole Foods is ultimately the better grocery store because it offers more environmentally friendly products, organic produce, and healthy alternatives to traditional medicine. First body paragraph. Discuss point one of the first subject. Example. Whole Foods offers a wide selection of environmentally friendly products. Second body paragraph. Discuss point two of the first subject. Example. Whole Foods has a wide selection of organic produce. Third body paragraph. Discuss point 3 of the first subject. Example. Whole Foods has a wider availability of healthy alternatives to medications. Fourth body paragraph. Transition to end example. Safeway does not offer very many. Discuss point one of the second subject, environmentally friendly products. Most of the providing similarities and differences with cleaning products and packaging sold by point one of the first subject. Safeway are not biodegradable and contain harmful chemicals that pollute our environment. Fifth body paragraph. Discuss point two of example. Safeway does not have as wide as the second subject, providing similarities and selection of organic produce as Whole Foods. Differences with point two of the first subject. Instead, the majority of its produce is grown with pesticides and hormones. Sixth body paragraph. Discuss point 3 of the second subject, providing similarities and differences with point 3 of the first subject. Example, Safeway offers very few natural remedies, Instead, Safeway has a large selection of over-the-counter drugs in addition to pharmacy that sells medications manufactured by pharmaceutical companies. Conclusion. Without repeating any claims or adding any new information, emphasize the importance of the similarities and differences between the two subjects, as they are relevant too. Your thesis. Example. With its wholesome products, Whole Foods is surely a healthier place to shop than Safeway. So let's talk about point-by-point approach. This organizational pattern is most effective when used on longer essays, such as comparison of two articles, short stories, or novels. The body of such an essay is organized by discussing one point at a time and how it applies to each subject before moving on to the next point. For long works, at least 3 points should be examined, if not more. Note, unlike the first option for organization, this pattern will probably require more than one body paragraph for each point being discussed. Introduction. Introduce the two or more subjects being compared and lead to a thesis, statement or argument. Example. There are benefits to shopping at both Whole Foods and Safeway, but Whole's because it offers more environmentally friendly products, organic produce, and healthy alternatives to traditional medicine. First point. Discuss point one of both subjects, comparing and contrasting the manifestation of this point in each subject. Example. Whole Foods offers a wide selection of environmentally friendly products, unlike Safeway, whose cleaning products and packaging are not biodegradable and contain harmful chemicals that pollute our environment. Second point, discuss point two of both example. While Whole Foods has a wide subject comparing and contrasting the selection of organic produce, the majority of manifestation of this point in its subject. Safeway's produce is grown with pesticides and hormones. Third point, discuss point three of both subjects comparing and contrasting the manifestation of this point in each subject. Example, Whole Foods has a wide availability of healthy alternatives to medications than Safeway, which has a large selection of over-the-counter drugs in addition to a pharmacy that sells medications manufactured by pharmaceutical companies. Conclusion. Without repeating any claims or adding any new information, emphasize the importance of the similarities and differences between the two subjects as they are relevant to your thesis. Example. With its wholesome products, Whole Foods is surely a healthier place to shop than Safeway. So let's talk about how to write a comparison contrast essay. The two items should make sense to compare or contrast. For example, you might compare two baseball teams, but not a football team and a baseball team. As you select your topic, keep in mind that you won't merely be describing the two things you are writing about. You will be emphasizing the ways they are different or alike. For instance, how does a math teacher you have job you had as a receptionist last summer. Second, the introduction should give the reason for the comparison or contrast. For example, to determine which is the more or less desirable of the two. The thesis statement should clearly present the two items to be compared, or contrasted. The subject and the criteria for the comparison or contrast. The main points. The main points must be grammatically parallel. The main points must apply equally to both items. For example, if you are comparing typewriters to word processors, the categories of screen size or color may not apply. So, organization of main points, the point-by-point method, also called the slice or alternating method, compares the items one point at the cost of attending high school and college, workload in high school and college, social aspects of high school and college. Using the point-by-point method helps you readers see the points more clearly. You would then need to blueprint 5 paragraphs for your essay. So let's speak about introduction and thesis. Items to be compared, reason for comparison, and main points. Body of paragraph. Cost of attending high school and college. Workload in high school and college. Social aspects of high school and college. Conclusion. Should summarize or restate the main points and may indicate a preference for one of the two items being compared. So these are the important points covered in this lecture. First, comparison. Contrast is a common pattern for writing about similarities and differences. It is used in all academic fields. There are two common ways to organize a comparison-contrast essay. In point-by-point organization, you discuss each similarity and each difference in some other order, usually order of their importance, without grouping them into blocks. In this type of organization, you may discuss a similarity and then a difference, and then a similarity and then a difference. In block organization, you first discuss all the similarities in a block and then all the differences in another block. You may, of course, begin with the block of differences. Use comparison and contrast signal words to help your reader understand your points of comparison and contrast. So, and questions which you have to answer. What is the first key to writing a successful comparison-contrast essay? What transition words and phrases do you know? What subordinates do you know? What is the function of contrast signal words and what is comparison-contrast? And sources which you can use in order to be ready for your practical lessons.